Prokaryotes are unicellular organisms that lack nucleus and membrane-bound organelles. They are divided into two domains, bacteria and archaea. A bacterial cell contains fimbriae, which are hair-like appendages that help cells adhere to other cells and to a substrate. Capsule is a sticky layer of polysaccharide or protein that can help cell attach or evade a host immune system. Inside the capsule are two more layers, including the cell wall and the cell membrane. Bacterial cells lack nucleus. Their DNAs are found in a region called nucleoid. They have circular chromosome that is often accompanied by smaller rings of DNA called plasmids. They have ribosomes that synthesize proteins. Some bacterial cells have appendage called pili that transfer DNAs between bacterial cells. And finally, most motile bacteria propel themselves by flagella, which are structurally and functionally different from eukaryotic flagella. A bacterial flagellum contains a motor, which is a system of rings embedded in the cell wall and the plasma membrane. Chemiosmosis of protons provides a force that turns the curved hook and thereby causes the attached filament to rotate and propel the cell. The three most common shapes of bacterial cells are rods or bacilli, spheres or cocci, and spirals. Bacterial cell walls contain peptidoglycan, which is a network of sugar polymers cross-linked by polypeptides. Using the Gram stain, scientists classify many bacterial species into gram-positive and gram-negative groups based on cell wall composition. The cell wall of gram-positive bacteria contains a thick layer of peptidoglycan, which traps crystal violet, making it purple under Gram stain. On the other hand, gram-negative bacteria have a thin layer of peptidoglycan, which is located between plasma membrane and an outer membrane, which contains lipopolysaccharides that can be toxic and more likely to be antibiotic resistant. The crystal violet can easily pass through this thin cell wall and be removed by alcohol rinse, revealing red dye under Gram stain. Prokaryotes have considerable genetic variation. Three factors contribute to this genetic diversity. First, prokaryotes reproduce rapidly by binary fission. And as a consequence of rapid reproduction, mutations can accumulate rapidly in a population. And the third factor that contributes to prokaryotic genetic diversity is through genetic recombination, which is the exchange of genetic material between different organisms. Prokaryotes undergo genetic recombination through three main mechanisms. First, a prokaryotic cell can take up and incorporate foreign DNA from the surrounding environment in a process called transformation. Second, conjugation transfer genetic material between bacterial cells through sex pili, which is plural for sex pilus. A piece of DNA called the F factor is required for the production of sex pili. The F factor can exist as a separate plasmid or as DNA within the bacterial chromosome, known as high-frequency recombination. Lastly, transduction transfer genes between bacteria by bacteriophages, which are viruses that infect bacteria. Now I'm going to talk about some major groups of bacteria. Proteobacteria is a large and diverse clade of gram-negative bacteria that includes five subgroups. Alpha proteobacteria includes the rhizobium species that live in nodules within the roots of legumes, where the bacteria convert atmospheric nitrogen to compounds that the host plant can use to make proteins. Another genus called Agrobacterium produces tumors in plants, which has been used to create genetically modified plants. Beta proteobacteria includes Nitrosomonas, which are soil bacteria that play an important role in nitrogen cycling by oxidizing ammonium, producing nitrite as a waste product. Beta proteobacteria also includes the species that causes gonorrhea. Gamma proteobacteria include chemoautotrophs known as sulfur bacteria that obtain energy by oxidizing hydrogen sulfide, producing sulfur as a waste product. Gamma proteobacteria also includes E. coli, which is a common resident of the intestines of humans, as well as Salmonella, which is responsible for some cases of food poisoning. Delta proteobacteria include slime-secreting myxobacteria. When the soil dries out or food is scarce, the cells congregate into a fruiting body that releases resistant myxospores, which found new colonies in favorable environments. Bedellovibrios is another group of delta proteobacteria, which attack other bacteria. The last subgroup, epsilon proteobacteria, include Campylobacter, which causes blood poisoning and intestinal inflammation, and Helicobacter pylori, or H. pylori, which causes stomach ulcers. Chlamydias are a group of intracellular parasites that lack peptidoglycan. They can only survive within animal cells. One species called Chlamydia trachomatis is the most common cause of blindness in the world. It also causes non-gonococcal urethritis, a sexually transmitted disease that causes inflammation of the urethra. Spirochetes are a group of gram-negative heterotrophs that spiral through their environment by means of rotating internal flagellum-like filaments. Many spirochetes are free-living, while others are pathogenic parasites, including species that causes syphilis and Lyme disease. Cyanobacteria are a group of gram-negative photoautotrophs that can carry out oxygen-generating photosynthesis. Chloroplast is likely evolved from an endosymbiotic cyanobacterium. Cyanobacteria are key component of freshwater and marine phytoplankton, a collection of photosynthetic organisms that drift near the water's surface. Some filaments have cells specialized for nitrogen fixation. The last major group is gram-positive bacteria, which is highly diverse. One subgroup called actinomycetes form colonies containing branch chains of cells, which may cause tuberculosis and leprosy. Streptomyces is another group of gram-positive bacteria. They are cultured by pharmaceutical companies as a source of many antibiotics, including streptomycin. Gram-positive bacteria also include Bacillus anthracis, which causes anthrax, Clostridium botulinum, which causes botulism, Staphylococcus, Streptococcus, and Mycoplasmas, which are the tiniest known cells, with diameters as small as 0.1 micrometers. They are also the only bacteria known to lack cell walls. Archaea are prokaryotes that share certain traits with bacteria and other traits with eukaryotes. The compare and contrast among bacteria, archaea, and eukarya have been covered in my video titled Three Domains of Life. Some archaea live in extreme environments and are called extremophiles. Extreme halophiles, halo meaning salt and philes meaning loving, live in highly salty environments. Whereas extreme thermophiles, thermo meaning heat and phile meaning loving, live in very hot environments. Another group of archaea known as methanogens live in swamps and marshes and produce methane as a waste product. And they are obligate anaerobes, which are poisoned by oxygen and use fermentation or anaerobic respiration. In contrast, facultative anaerobes survive with or without oxygen. And obligate aerobes require oxygen for cellular respiration. Some other key terms for prokaryotes include endospore, which is a dormant, tough, non-reproductive structure produced by some bacteria. Heterocytes refer to the nitrogen-fixing cell in cyanobacteria. Lastly, pathogenic prokaryotes cause disease by releasing two types of toxins. Exotoxins are proteins secreted by certain bacteria. They can cause disease even when the prokaryotes that produce them are absent. Endotoxins are lipopolysaccharide component of outer membrane of gram-negative bacteria. They are released only when bacteria die and their cell walls break down.